I almost forgot the reason why I was standing in front of a mirror while I was filming this. It's because I wanted to do an OOTD. Okay, let's start off with a t-shirt that I'm wearing. This is over 10 years old. I think my mom got this for me in Hong Kong back in either 2007 or 2008. So it's almost 2020. So yeah, this t-shirt is old. This is a secondhand pair of jeans. This is called from the brand Density Jeans. It was a pair of jeans and I cut it up and turned it into a skirt because I already have way too many jeans. So sandals are secondhand Doc Martens that I believe it was from Depop that I got this from. Okay, I've got my watch I bought last year, Fitbit Versa. There's going to be a lot of walking today, so I thought I'd bring that in. Earrings are pearl earrings that I got from the Rocks Market from a Filipina seller. This bangle here, I got from, where did I get this? Salvos in Chatswood for $5. Okay, and then of course it's my engagement ring and my wedding ring right there. So that's what we're wearing today. And then of course my lovely Burberry bag. Okay, so I'm here at on Elizabeth Street and one of the bus stops because I'm waiting for my bus, the 304, to get here to go to the Surrey Hills Vintage Market. I don't really have anything in particular that I am looking for, and sometimes that's dangerous, but today and tomorrow I'm going to be quite strict with myself. I'm really only looking for a black leather loafers for myself. And then gifts for members of my family, but that's it. I actually already have quite a few gifts, so all of the females in my family have their gifts already. It'll just be my brothers that I need to find something for, so we'll see how that goes. But yeah, okay, so we're here now at the Surrey Hills Market. And before I take out any money from the bank, I'd like to just go around first and see if there's anything worth getting at the moment. But there's loads of vintage stuff in here. Secondhand catch, it says on that one board there. This one in here is cute. It's mint green, but it's $30. So, safe to say I'm not buying that. This one shop here called Not Too Shabby looks like it's got a few things that are nice. This ones look like they're still new. This shop right across from me was quite interesting. They had all of these like designer brands like Chanel, Dior, Fendi, Gucci, Louis Vuitton. Okay, so while I was there, I also ended up buying two scarves from Pretty Fucking Vintage, which is already somebody that I follow on Instagram. So when I saw her booth, I decided I was gonna go and get something from there. Now it is 9:22. I'm probably gonna go get something to eat for breakfast and then head over to Knopf's Op Shops, which opens at 10. So my thought process is if I'm going to get something for that much amount of money, I might as well get them secondhand and authentic from, let's say, Japan. Like $520 for a fake brand new Fendi, that's a lot of money. I can already get a real Fendi secondhand from Japan with that money and some change. So I'm just waiting for the Knopf's Op Shop to actually open. And I'll probably get a bus over there to go to Randwick. Okay, so when you get off the bus stop, it's right at Vinny's. So I'm just going to go in here because I've never been here before. Okay, so next to Vinny's over there is the Red Cross shop over here. So we're going in. Okay, so here we are. I found the Knopf's op shops. Everything under $5 or less. They have special racks. This one is bigger than the ones that I've been to before. Okay, so I changed my mind about going to Blue Spinach because I found their website. And not only was it really expensive still, but I don't really have anything that I'm interested in. So instead, I'm going to go to Vinny's. Hey. Okay, so Vinny's didn't really have anything that I was interested in. So I am now going to walk over to U-Turn Vintage and see if I can find something that I like. But just very quickly, Fabric Vintage. Look at those cowboy boots. They're just a bit more expensive than what I'm willing to pay for them. They're usually around $60. Of course, I won't be able to pass up this opportunity to go in here. Okay, I'm home finally, and I'm gonna do a little haul for you guys. And I think there's gonna be a change of plans. So instead of doing this as a Saturday and Sunday vlog, this is just gonna be a Saturday vlog because the length of the footages that I already have is enough for one vlog. And plus, I'm not sure if I'm gonna go to the Kirribilli markets tomorrow, given that I spent so much today. Anyway, I'm gonna do this haul and do it in chronological order, which means show you what I bought in the order that I bought them. So over at the Surrey Hills Vintage Market, I went there and got two scarves from Pretty Frocking Vintage, who I've already bought from before. I bought like two dresses from her. This is one of the prints from the scarf, and I thought it was really beautiful. So I have this. I don't actually know where it's from, but it kind of makes me think Versace kind of vibe, although it's not a Versace. And then this one, I just thought it was a lovely, beautiful nautical color there. And what I intend to do with these ones are to wrap them around my bags. These two were $15 for both. The designer scarves that I was looking at in that shop that was selling like replica bags was $30 each. I mean, the quality of those ones were nice, but I'm not gonna spend $30 on a scarf, no way, unless they're like 100% silk. Okay, and then when I went to Randwick with the intention of going to Knopf's op shop, I first stopped by the, what do you call this, Vinny's, as I got down from the bus, and I found two things that I bought. Okay, one of them is this Longchamp bag. It's I think this is the small one because it's like most of the ones that I see are massive like totes, and this is just a small one. And it was only for $6. Granted, some of the glazing on the leather is coming off. Actually, most of it are coming out, so I might have to bring this to a repair person and get that reglazed. I'm thinking that I will actually bring this to the Philippines and get it done there because it's probably going to be much cheaper to get it done back home than to bring it over to a professional here. But it's still in really good condition. The nylon of the bag, I think it is nylon, I'm not 100% sure, it's still pretty good. I just need to wash it because the inside is a little bit dirty. And it says Le Pliage Longchamp type, I think. And it says made in France. Yeah, most of the leather trimmings, the glazings are coming off, so I'm gonna have to get that redone. But like, it's still quite beautiful. At first I was like, this can't possibly be a real Longchamp because it's like $6. And I don't know if it is because I've never owned a Longchamp before. I don't know how to authenticate them. But for $6, and what I like about it is that it is like you can fold it to a smaller bag, so that makes it easier for to travel with. And I think that was the whole intention of this bag in the first place. So $6 for a Longchamp, not bad. Okay, so that was that one. And then I got a bracelet from that place as well, from Vinny's. Let me just find where it is. Oh, here we go. I thought this was an interesting interesting bracelet to accessorize with, so I got it. And it's just really like a chain with a few charms on it. And I do like the black and silver kind of rustic metal look on it. It was $4, which is a little bit cheap, a little bit expensive for what it is, but I don't really mind. That's that. And then I didn't find anything, or I didn't buy anything from the Red Cross shop that I showed you guys, but I was really tempted by one bag there. It was a Todd's bag, and it was like a beautiful tan with really beautiful leather. It was in excellent condition, but I was like, I don't need another bag. Forget that I said that, okay? But I left it behind. It was $75, which is pretty good for a Todd's bag, but it wasn't really just something that I wanted to get. But I went to Knopf's Op Shop and I found this Billabong shorts. This is in a size 32, and I'm hoping that it would fit Duncan because I bought it for him. It's just gonna go into the wash. If it doesn't fit Duncan, I'm gonna bring it home to Manila next week and have my brothers use it for them. Especially one of my brothers, he does surf. He goes to Siargao, to La Union, to Aurora in Baler, and he goes surfing there. So he might appreciate that if it doesn't end up with Duncan. Okay, that was $5, by the way, that Billabong shorts, and it's in perfect condition. I don't know why. And then for myself, I was actually looking at these half shoes that I really wanted to get, but I wanted like the Gucci kind of half shoes. But then I found these. I should probably put it that way. These are by Winsor Smith. It's got that horse bit kind of detail that Gucci does. But these were $5. The Gucci ones are, I think, $650, the brand new ones. So I think this is a really good buy. Really nice leather material, $5. You can't go wrong. Okay, so I'm taking this with me to Manila. While I was there, I also bought some accessories. These are dangling earrings, and I like that it's got that little like sort of crystal inside there. It's pretty cute. This was $3 and it's new. I also found this necklace here, which I love the details of, the braid. This was also $3. It was, it's a little scuffing, so it's not perfect, but for $3, it's okay. I also bought these double-ended belts, okay. Because I just really like the detail, that like Western detail on this one. So, but with their size, they would only actually fit me if both ends are in the first hole. So, but it should, okay, it should look like that. Ideally, it should be over the last one. Okay, I'm sure you've seen some of these belts before. Okay, ideally it should be at the very last one so that the belt buckles are right next to each other. But realistically, I don't have the waistline to do that. So it should look like that, but mine is going to be like over here. But it's still quite cute, right? So that was $3 as well. And that's everything that I bought from Knopf's Op Shop. Now, you would have seen that I also stopped over at, what do you call this? U-Turn Vintage, which is my favorite spot to go to, and I always find really good bags there. So the moment I walked in, there was one bag that really caught my eye, but I'm going to show you that last. Before, the last time I was there, I actually found this Furla bag. It's a white Furla. It's got some damage already at the bottom, but I have a leather paint that I could use to fix those edges there. There's also some, I think these are like nail polish drips right there that I can take off and clean up. And this is still really good. Like, it even has the padlock and it's really good leather. It needs a little bit of cleaning, but it's still in good condition. And I intend to resell this. This isn't gonna stay with me. Yeah, like, look, I just need to clean up the insides as well because there's a bit of staining. Obviously, it hasn't been well taken care of by the previous owner. And I got this for, how much was this? $29. So I'm gonna clean this up and I'm gonna resell it and make money out of it. That was the intention, that's why I bought it. The next one is also intended for resale. And here in Australia, this is a pretty famous brand. I wouldn't say it's designer, but it's like along the same lines or the same price points as Lacoste and, what are their, Fossil, something like that. This is a Mimco bag. And what caught my eye with this one is that is the closure. So it comes with this chain, like an antique gold chain. It's beautiful. It's got Mimco there. It also has that faux croc styling on the front. When you unclasp that and you open it, it's got, it's pretty clean inside, like it hasn't been used. At first, I was actually tempted to keep this with me, but we all know I already have a lot of crossbody bags, okay? This was $39, and it's in really good condition, really beautiful. So there you go, Mimco. So that's that. Again, this is gonna be cleaned and resold. Perfect. Hardware, perfect leather. Yep. So that's gonna get rehomed. I'm really tempted because this feature here is so beautiful, but I already have others that will do the same job. The one that I am most excited about, and I don't know why this was priced this low, but thankfully it was. Okay, so this one is the one that I am most excited about. And let me just put this back in its proper order. Now, I found this. This is a Fendi spy bag that has been discontinued in the fall of 2012. Everything else looks legit on this one. I actually don't have any idea what this compartment is for. Maybe for cigarettes or something. I don't smoke, so I'll probably like put lip balm in there. So it's got Fendi there. It's got the reverse Fendi there, which everything else I've seen is that way. Fendi over there. I just don't get what this one is for. Like, shouldn't it hang somewhere? Anyway, so it also has this little pocket in here. And it's got that Zucca print inside. Beautiful, looks legit, authentic. Okay. When you open that up, okay, let me just, the leather, by the way, is really, really good. It has that Fendi sign there, the embossing, which I've seen in other spy bags to be correct. It has that sort of like serial number on that leather, which I've already looked up. And it is the, it comes up with this kind of bag. However, the giveaway that this is not a legit bag is this tag right here. Normally, a legitimate Fendi bag of this kind, this particular design, would have what is a hologram tag on here that would have the serial number. Here it has a serial number there. It's A497663, which I have read from my research is a known fake number. And the real Fendi bags, these are unique. No two bags would have the same number. And apparently this has been printed on several fakes, okay? And in this blank area here, there should be a hologram tag on there, and there isn't one. So that's the only indication that this is not an authentic Fendi bag, but more so a replica. But for a replica, this is a really good replica, if I do say so myself. The quality of the cloth that is used for the Zuka print is just really beautiful. It looks legit. With the exception of that hologram tag, you would never be able to tell that this was a replica bag, because the leather is gorgeous. The braiding of the edges is beautiful. The handles are gorgeous. Yeah. And if I didn't tell you, you probably would think that this was real as well. I got this for $29, which is not a bad deal for the beautiful leather that it is. So even if it turned out that it was a replica bag, I'm not even sure if it is a replica bag. I just searched that there should be a hologram. I don't know if all of them have it, or if that was an addition to later models after so many fakers came out with a replica. This could still be a real bag without the hologram. I don't know. Anyway, whether or not it is, it's a beautiful bag, and I am keeping this for myself. Okay? It's just gorgeous. I'm just going to have to clean it up because it's quite dusty. I can feel it in my hands. But yes, that is my haul from thrift shopping. I spent $97 on those three bags plus 5, 10, 19 here. 97 plus 19, what is that? $116 plus 10, 126 plus 15, $141 in total. With the intention of reselling two of the bags, hopefully I would be able to recover that cost. Yeah. Okay, that's it for today. If I do end up going to the Kirribilli markets tomorrow, I might try and go to some other places. Just so that it's not a waste of like one vlog. But if I don't, then I will see you all again in the next video. Bye.